In today's video, you can expect to learn how to get started with Tradovate, how to set up the charting platform itself, how to connect Tradovate to your funding companies such as Topstep, UProfit, Apex, Profit Trader, and any company that offers Tradovate. And then I'm going to show you guys how to connect Tradovate to Tradingview. That way you can trade with Tradingview because I believe it is by far the best platform out there. Overall, a great trading platform. On my channel, there's no BS, no guru jargon, just straight up value. With that being said, let's go ahead and jump straight into it. I recommend you download Tradovate. You can download it for Windows or Mac. If you're with a funding company, you would use the username and password that the funding company gave you to log in. If you are just looking to open an account with them, you would push join now and then they'll give you username and password. I'm going to go ahead and use Take Profits username and password they gave me. I'm going to push login. Now, when you first come to here, you have market replay. You also have simulation. We're going to go simulation. All right. So I have a chart set up here in a DOM. I'm going to show you guys how to customize your chart and set up the DOM. It's super important that you set it up the way that you like. I think that's important. Because you're going to have it the way you want, and I'll show you how to customize it. To put a chart on here, you're going to go to modules, and then each module is a different thing. You can put multiple on a chart. If you go to Tradovate workspaces here, they have some that are already made. You have a replay workspace if you want. I'm just going to leave it how it is, but let's say for the sake of this, let's say you wanted to put a DOM on your chart. You grab the DOM. And then you would put it in the right here. Then any symbol, any chart you pull up, you're going to have to put in the symbol. If you're trading ES, it would be ES. And then the first one that pops up is always going to be the current contract. You're going to want to choose that one. Now you have your DOM here, right? If you go to settings, you can have show is histogram, which shows the past bid and ask orders. You can say show join bid ask. You can have show pulling and stacking, which is manipulation of the DOM. It will show when people are pulling orders, which can help show which side is more aggressive. You go to stop type and then stop. And a stop limit is going to trigger at a certain price, a trailing stop that you can set to trail you on a certain amount of ticks. And you also have a trailing stop limit. If you go to settings here, you have limit orders, left click, stop order, right click. So let's say I wanted to buy here. I'm just going to go buy market. Boom. Now I'm in the market. It shows that I'm in the market right there. Now, how do I set a stop? If you come, you can do it on here. Let's say you wanted to put your stop there. You just left click and then it'll pull up. Now I'll push sell stop one. And now you can see my stops right here. Let's say I want to exit. You just exit like that. And now I'm all out of the market. Now let's say I wanted to go short. I'm going to go sell market. Now I'm in the market short. Let's say I want to put my stop there, or let's say a little bit higher, let's say the high of the session so far, put buy stop. So there, now my stop's in the market. You can also do it here on the DOM. You can move it, or you can exit it, or then you can put it here as well. I bought, and now if I want to put a stop in the market, I need to right click. It will put a stop in the market for you. Now, let's see, it works there. Yeah, it does the same thing. So you have to right click and then it will put a stop there. If you go to settings here, you can have it right click or left click for your limit stop order. All right, now let's go to the next thing. Let's go over how to customize your chart. Now I have a blank screen. Let's go ahead and add chart. We're going to pull it here and we're going to put in ES, the first one that's steps up is always going to be the most recent contract. I like to trade ES and NQ together. So I'm going to push chart again. I'm going to push it right here. It separates the two. Push NQ. And then for any other products you want, you would just push the first two letters of the ticker symbol. Now I have my two charts here. What else would I want on here? I don't have a DOM on there when I trade, but if you wanted one, you could put it on there. I like to have positions. I'm going to put this at the bottom here like that. And then I don't have any positions on, but when we do, you'll see them there. You can slide this up and down as much as you like. I like to just have it there so I can push cancel all and exit, which I'll show you what I mean by that. Let's say I wanted to enter the market right now. I would go buy market. You will hear an order filled. And then now, see, that's why I like to have positions here, is because now I could exit if I wanted to. Let's say I wanted to buy one on ES as well. Now I can cancel these anytime I want. That's why I like to have the positions down there. Let's say I wanted to put my stop right here. I would go sell one stop. Then anytime you want to expand the chart, you just scroll up on your mouse and it does that. Let's say I wanted to put my stop right here. Then I would just click there and then click sell one stop. Now I have stops in the market. You can also change the time period by going to the minute button there. They have all kinds of different, you know, charts you can set up. They even have second charts. And then candlesticks, they have a whole grip of different ones. Let's go look at some more modules here. You can have order tickets. The only other one I like using a lot is the statistics. To get your trading performance, you click this one. And now you could put it right below positions. And then anytime you wanted to look at this, you could just pull it like this. Boom, be like, oh, I want to check my trading stats. And then you can do that. And then you just put it, grab it and pull it back like that. Boom. Very clean, right? Very easy to use. That way you can, I like to slide it down and up a little bit more. Or you can just put up a second window or something like that too. You can do that like this. You go up here, you push it up there. Now you can look at your stats over here. You have it there, and you could even do that with your positions. You could go put it up here like that. You can get really customized in how you want it. Anytime you want to check which account you're trading with, it's right here. You click that. If you have multiple accounts, you can scroll down like that. Anytime you're confused and you don't understand or you need some help with something, you can always go right here and click help. And then it will give you a breakdown. I'll walk you exactly through it. It's a whole tutorial. You can do that. If you push that button there, it has help for all of it, right? It's pretty in-depth and tells you how to do it. One of my favorite things about Tradovate is their statistics. Let's go ahead and put that on our chart. We're going to go to Performance Center. We're going to press it. I already have it up there. Now we're going to go to Performance Center right here. Then we're going to click here to view performance of past days. All right, if you go to this week and then push go, it's going to show your P&L for the week. Now it's going to have a pretty, this is one of the best things about Tradovate that I don't think people are utilizing. You have all your trades, profit trades, losing trades, and your winning percentage is minus 61%, which is right in line. And then my P&L for the week is $1,900, $1,800, somewhere around there. It shows P&L distribution, like time of day, per time of day. And then it shows you everything you really need to know to be able to improve your trading. Now I'm going to show you guys how you can set up and get your Tradovate connected to your funding platform, whether that be TopStep or Apex Trader Funding, either or. I'm going to show you guys how you can set it up to get it all set up so you can trade on Tradingview, because it is a lot better, I'll tell you what. Okay, the first step is to go ahead and sign into your funding company. For this example, I'm going to do both TopStep and Apex. Let's say you're Apex, you're going to log in. Now, when you scroll down, you're going to see you have your Rhythmic username and password and your Tradovate username and password. Go ahead and copy your Tradovate username and password. Now we're going to Google Tradovate and we're going to go to login. Now we're going to copy and paste our username and password into Tradovate from Apex and then push login. Now it's going to have a simulation here. Ignore this. I'm not sure why it keeps doing that on my computer, but push continue. And now I'm signed in under Apex. You're going to want to go ahead and go over to this right here, push application settings, and then we're going to go to add-ons and then press activate Tradingview, and any of the other ones that are free, just go ahead and push activate. You can go ahead and exit there and make sure you push down here and log out. Now we're going to go to Tradingview. I suggest you download Tradingview on your desktop. It is the desktop version is much, much better. From here, you're going to push this little menu button up, choose Tradovate. Now, the same username and password that you just used that is from Apex's dashboard. You're going to copy and paste it into there, push connect. Okay, you're going to click there, put your username and password in there, just as you did to sign into Tradovate, and push connect. Now you are connected. From there, you're going to minus that out. These buy and sell buttons you can buy with, but if you double click on the chart anywhere and go to trading, you're going to want to click on buy sell button, instant order placement, and then turn this to rejection only, or else every single order is going to pop up. I like to have positions on, profit and loss, reverse button, orders, brackets, profit and loss. Extend price lines for orders, execution, and positions. Now you see there, you can left click anywhere on the chart or right click anywhere on the chart. Then you go to trade, you can create new order. This is how you would set up a bracket. You can do take profit, stop loss. I personally don't use them, but you could. Or you can come over here to this button right here and you can push sell stop, buy stop, or you can just enter how I like to enter. I like to just enter up the chart with these buttons right here. Boom. Just like that. Now I'm in the market. If I want to put a stop loss, I just use this right here. Sell to stop limit. There's also a DOM. If you guys are interested in getting funded, I actually have a website that I update every day with the newest discounts. It is verified funding companies. Once you get to the homepage here, if you click right here, it will take you to the discount page. I update this every single day. There's a new discount. You can subscribe to my newsletter. It was just mainly discounts at first, but now I'm moving towards more tips and tricks for trading and passing evaluations. So make sure you subscribe to get the newest discounts and tips and tricks delivered to your email. Blue Knox Trader Funding has a sale, 90% off. That's right, 90% off if you use the code KING90. Make sure you click on the button here or here to get the discount. Apex Trader Funding, same deal, 90% off, ends tomorrow. Take Profit Trader, which is probably my new favorite funding company. I really like their payouts. I like their owners. You use TradingView and Rhythmic. There's a lot of things I like about them. If right now they have probably the best discount there is in terms of fees, although Apex and Blue Knox might be a little bit cheaper, but right now you get 40% off the evals, right? And then once you pass, you don't pay an activation fee. So that's saving you $130 for a 50K account. That's a super good deal. Top Step Trader Funding, they have a legit deal too. You have 50K for only 50, 100K for 99, and 150K for 149. All right, since you guys watched to the very end, I'm going to hook you guys up. And since you guys have watched all the way to the very last, until the very end, I'm going to hook you guys up with a chance to win a free Blue Knox Trader Funding evaluation. Blue Knox is the trader funding company that actually really changed my life. So that's why I give away the accounts. They're the first funding company I got really big payouts with that allowed me to quit my job. The contest rules are one entry per person. You can only win once per contest, and the winners will be chosen by random. On October 13th, I'll release a video with the winner. To enter, you need to like the video, subscribe to my channel, comment below what types of videos you would like to see, whether that be reviews, trading strategies, and so on like that. And last but not least, go ahead and click on the right-hand corner on the screen right now. That's going to take you to my website and my newsletter. Go ahead and click that and subscribe to my newsletter, and then you're in the giveaway. Appreciate you guys watching. Hope this helps you in your journey to become a full-time trader.